this previous condition. So welcome back again. My name is Jesse, and in this wonderful discussion, learn about the power of systems, the power of systems, understanding the power of systems, why you and I need a system. So the world is running on a system. God runs this planet called Earth. God runs this vast, gigantic universe on something called a system, right? So the reason why God is not stressed about anything happening, going up and down, is because he's running this world based on a system. So one of the ways that God ruled this planet and ruled the entire universe is using a system. There are laws and there are also systems, right? So that is one of the ways God creates and God rules this planet. So as a matter of fact, you and I are running on a system. My body is running on 12 different systems. Your body is also running on 12 different systems, which is very, very interesting. You have about different systems. You have the immune system, the blood system, the digestive system. You have several systems running your body to make sure that you are alive. When God created Adam and Eve, he created just two people, Adam and Eve. Now we have about 7 billion people. It has been estimated that the number of people who have lived on the earth is more than about 25 billion people that has come upon this planet called earth. And are, of course, they are going to increase, and of course, there are going to be more people. God created only two. But how is it possible that all of these will be to come? The reason that God created a system. The system he created was the reproductive system and then the family system. So God created two systems. The reproductive system and then the family system. And the other system that God created to make sure that everything is running perfectly. There's something they call the hydrological system, right? Or the water cycle for short. Every day God does not have to come from heaven above to make sure that it rains, right? He has created a system in place. There is the sun. There's the sun, right? There's the sun shining. The sun shines every day. And then there is the moon. And then there's all of these things, right? The sun shines on the rivers, the streams, the sea, or the soil, and it causes evaporation of water. The water goes up, it converges to form clouds. The clouds produce rains, right? So that is the system God has created. That every day they don't have to come down from heaven above to make sure that it's raining. The same way, when there's an invasion of bacteria in your body, God does not have to come from heaven above to make sure that the bacteria is cleansed. He has placed a system in place called the immune system that kicks in and then clears the disease away. Can you imagine God every day coming, every day in the morning or in afternoon or anytime you are diseased to make sure that it is cleared? That is a lot of waste of time and energy and resources. So the purpose of every system is to save us a lot of things, to save us stress, save us time, save us energy, save us a lot of things. So we will discuss about the importance and essence of a system. Now let's see what a system is, another example of a system. So for example, like let's say you eat food, right? When you eat food, it goes through your digestive system and produces two byproducts. Right? The byproduct and an end product. So the end product is going to be the nutrients you're going to get, the energy you're going to get from the food you eat. And it's going to produce another byproduct, which is going to go through the soil, right? And it's going to serve as manure for the soil. Then the plant will feed on those soil, get nutrients from it, and then produce fruit. Right, so just like the nitrogen cycle, then it goes produce food, fruits, and then you take the food and eat. So that is a cycle, that is a system that God has already produced to make sure that you and I are running, the plants are running, we are running, and everything in this world is running perfectly. So that is how God runs this world. Imagine not using a system. Can you imagine the number of stress God is going to pass through? So systems are very, very important. People that rule the world are running the world on system. The reason why some few people can rule the entire world is that they are running the world based on the system. They have created several systems that is in place and making sure that the world is running on their system. So we have the education system, which was created by some few people. We have the financial system, which is being ruled by some few people. We have the transport system. We have several systems in place that is running this world. If you take the education system as an example, it started, the current education system that we are using is an adaptation of a system that started from Prussia, right? Modern day Austria and Germany, some part of Germany. And then now the whole world has adapted that system and we are running on that system. And another man came called Henry Ford, some other people, and they also created different systems. They adapted the system and they modified the system to twist the education system to become a system of just like an assembly line. That you just go inside, which is a system, we are trained to become whatever we want to become. Like maybe doctors, teachers, and then we come back to the factory, we come out produce like that. So the world is running on a system. People that are ruling the world based on system. So one of the ways to rule your world, to rule your life, is to run your world or run your life based on a system. God uses system. Man has also learned to use systems. People that are running the world are running the world based on system. So if you are not using a system, that means that you are part of somebody's system. You are a component of somebody's system. So what makes something a system? Okay, so now let's see and learn it.
things that make something a system. So I call them the C's of a system, right? The seven C's of a system. And then we also have the P's of a system. So first of all, let's learn about what makes something a system so that you'll be able to create your own system. Number one, a system is a collection, right? So every system is a collection. It's a collection of what? It's a collection of components or different structures. So one of the ways of creating systems is just to see the different components that make something, right? That makes something a collection, that makes something as a whole. So number one, the system is a collection of components, and then all the components are connected together. Connectivity at the origin vajna. So connectivity is also very, very important. And then they are contributing, right? So they are contributing, and then they are following a course, right? A particular part, a particular thing they are supposed to do to produce a particular outcome. That is the last. And then they are following a clock. So a system is a collection of components that are connected together, and they are contributing together, following a course to produce what? An outcome. And then they are following or obeying a clock, right? A clock, which is time or a schedule. So every system has a schedule. Every system has a time that follows. So that is one of the, these are the components, the characteristics that make something a system. Characteristics, yes. Okay, so that is a system. Now let's see another thing that can make you understand a system. Let's take something like the transport system, for example, right? If you take the transport system or the train system, if you go to the train station, there is the train. We have the ticketing system or the billing system whereby you pay your ticket. We have the railroad, right? We have the rail lines. We have the train station. We have the cabins. We have the engines. We have the people that are working, the maintenance team, the repair team. All of these things are different components. They're all connected together to form the train or transport system. Every city, every major city is using a mass transit system. And the purpose of a mass transit system is to make sure that they carry people, they move people from one place to another place, right? With speed, with efficiency, and with effectiveness. That is one of the things, the benefit of a system. Systems makes you efficient and then effective. Processes makes you effective. Systems makes you efficient. Right. So now let's learn another different aspect of a system. So another aspect of a system, that systems have parts, right? These are the pieces of the systems. They have parts, and then they have a purpose, right? Every system must have a purpose. It must have a purpose to accomplish something, to accomplish a task. They have parts, they have a purpose, they have a plan. They have not only a plan, they have a period, right? A schedule they're supposed to follow. They have a path they're supposed to follow, like a path. They have a pattern. So one of the ways of building a system is to just sit down and observe the patterns, how things goes, right? They have a process, and then they have a patrol system. So a patrol system is just like the protection mechanism of a system. So the protection mechanism is just a feedback mechanism. If you go to the train station, there's the police, there is the people who are monitoring, there's a repair team. If you go to the airline station, you have people that are on the radar who are monitoring things to make sure that everything is in place, to give feedback, so that we to know what to change and what not to change. That is a system. So now let's learn about the principles of a system. So every system has some principles that it must follow. So the principle that every system must follow is that every system has, is like this, right? I don't know whether you can see it. We have an output. First of all, every system has an input, right? And then it goes through this to produce an output. I don't know whether I can see it. I don't know whether I can see my eyes. Can you see my eyes? Okay, so there's an input and an output, right? This stuff here is important, right? It's very important. But that does not make a system. This is just another aspect of a system. That's one of the principles of a system. There's an input and then there must be an output. But most people always concentrate on just the input and output. But in between this input and then this output, there is some other stuff. So what is here is that we have a period or time, and we have a process. Right? A process. So there is an input, a period, a process, an output. And then here, there's a feedback. Feedback or a patrol system. Right? So that is what makes a system. So anytime you want to create a system, you have to understand this particular principle, that there must be different parts of a system. Every system has different parts. There is an input, right? There is an output, the result you want. And then there is a period and then a process. And there's a feedback mechanism. It's not just an input. So if you want to change the result of your life, you want to change the result of any system, you should not only just consider the input, but also consider the process. Sometimes the process may be the wrong thing. Sometimes the period may be the wrong thing. Sometimes the feedback mechanism may be the wrong thing. That is why the output may be wrong. So you have to understand these particular components of a system. These are the basic principles of every system that is working. Let's use this for an example. If you take, let's say, if you take something different, like a digestive system, right? Or any system, like the food you eat, right? The food you eat is, you take the food, you have to eat the food. Based on the food that you're going to eat, will determine how you're going to be, whether you're going to become fat or you're going to become stronger. That is one of the things you're going to learn. You're going to be. But it's not only just that, but sometimes it depends on the period, right? The time you're going to eat the food, and then your body mechanism, what is going to, how it's going to process it. Because some people, they have very fast metabolism. They have very fast body type. So because they have very fast body, right, no matter the amount of food they eat, they're not going to become fat, right? Because they have a very powerful process. And some people, they have fast process, but their period in which they eat affects their input and affects their output. So that is something that you should learn about the basic principle of every system. So you should run your life on system. So why should you run your life on system? So systems are supposed to save us, right? Save you and I, yourself and others, from stress, right? Not only just strength, but save you from stress. And then save your time, your energy, your matter, and your money. God is using a system. You are using, you must also use a system. The people that rule the world are also running the world based on a system. They are using systems to save themselves time, energy, matter, and then stress. So that's one of the things that you should learn about systems. Systems helps you to run your life well. If you don't have a system, that means that somebody, you are part of somebody's system, right? So you have to learn how to create your own system, which is very, very important. I know I've talked a lot, you have learned a lot, you have heard about a lot, but you have to sit down and then see how to create your own system to run your world and run your life based on the system. You never regret. Thank you and stay blessed.